Hola amigos, bienvenidos a Insert Coin, soy Jaimix y hoy vamos a jugar a Shadow of the Comet. Estamos en el tercer vídeo de la guía del videojuego correspondiente al segundo día y estamos aquí en nuestra habitación donde tenemos que recoger del escritorio la receta de la medicina que va a evitar que tengamos nuevos desmayos. Así que nos vamos a dirigir hacia la farmacia para que nos hagan el preparado y tener dicha medicina.
So, let's read the prescription. Mix 1 milligram of digitalin with 1 milligram of adrenaline. Okay. Take 1 pill in case of stress or overwork.
Llegamos a la farmacia, vamos a entregar la receta al farmacéutico, el cual también nos va a ofrecer su zona de revelado para nuestra fotografía.
Hello, Mr. Matthews.
Mr. Parker, what a nice surprise. Darn it all, I'll get all that ready for you. It's going to take a while.
I have a favor to ask. I must develop my plates, you see, and...
Help yourself. It's the door at the end. I'll be with you as soon as I've finished. In case you've forgotten, you need to develop and fix your plates. That requires mixing 4 different chemical products. Find the products you need to mix for each preparation on the shelf.
Vamos a pasar a la zona de revelado, para lo cual vamos a tener que recoger una serie de productos químicos. Ahí tenemos encima de la mesa 4 botes, vamos a coger los 4 y luego en la zona de la derecha vamos a encontrar unas escaleras donde arriba del todo vamos a encontrar otros 4 botes con productos químicos. Los cogemos todos y después ya veremos cuáles son los que vamos a utilizar, ya que la sala de revelado se encuentra tras la cortina roja que vemos a la izquierda. Pasamos a la sala de revelado y lo primero que vamos a hacer es evidentemente apagar las luces que están en el interruptor que se encuentra debajo de la lámpara. Una vez que tenemos la luz roja, nos vamos hacia la izquierda y pasamos a colocar las placas fotográficas. Y ahora habrá que utilizar los productos químicos en el siguiente orden. Lo primero será la sosa cáustica.
A few drops of metal. Let's continue.
Posteriormente la hidroquinona.
A dash of hydroquinone. Well, let's see the fixing solutions. Let's continue.
Continuamos con el clorato de benzina.
The merest hint of sodium thiosulfate. Let's continue.
Y finalizamos con el cromogenous y con eso pues ya conseguimos revelar las fotos.
A sniff of potash metabisulfite. No problem. Perfect. How horrific! My heart!
Thank you. Thank you very much. Without you, I...
You see, that's a lot better already. Don't push your luck.
I'll try to remember that.
I'm counting on you. So is my daughter. That comes to $10. Thank you.
Don't worry.
The drugstore is open from 8 to 6. If you need more pills, just stop by and ask.
Thank you again.
Por suerte, el nuevo desmayo nos ha pillado en la farmacia y con las pastillas ya preparadas. Así que hemos podido salvarnos de esta. Así que todo lo que hemos descubierto con la fotografía requiere de mayor investigación.
Oh, quite a surprise, Mr. Parker. Isn't that right? You look kind of pale. You should think about your health.
You're most thoughtful, Mr. Coldstone. Aren't you a little too old to be out so late?
I can take care of myself. A word of advice. Stay away from the forest. There's something about it that doesn't agree with some folks.
Para seguir con nuestras pesquisas, nos vamos a ir a la casa hacia la casa de Jack. Pero vamos a descubrir de nuevo al misterioso personaje encapuchado y vamos a decidir seguirlo. Y vamos a ver qué se va a dirigir hacia la tienda de ultramarinos. Lo seguimos y vamos a ver que deja una llave encima del mostrador. Así que en cuanto la deja ahí, la recogemos y hablamos un poco con el tendero como para disimular un poquito.
So, how about the photos?
I just wanted to tell you your plates are still good.
Well, be sure to show me the results.
I'm sure you'd find them far too amateurish. In any case, I'll certainly be back for more very soon.
All right, but don't wait too long. Goodbye now.
Esta llave que hemos recogido nos permite abrir la casa de Jack, así que nos vamos a dirigir hacia allí.
This door is locked.
Una vez que estemos dentro, tenemos que recoger una estatuilla de cada una de las estancias. La primera que tenemos que coger es esa que estáis viendo ahí encima del escritorio, que se trata de la estatua de niño. Nos pasamos a la siguiente habitación. Aquí vamos a encontrarlo. Una nueva estatuilla ahí en el mueble ese del fondo. Para abrirlo, lo que tenemos que hacer es observarlo.
A statuette.
Que en este caso es la estatua del hombre joven. Y por último nos vamos hacia la habitación de la izquierda y en la vitrina de la derecha del todo vamos a encontrar una nueva estatuilla, que es la estatuilla del hombre viejo. Una vez que tenemos todas las estatuas, nos pasamos a la siguiente habitación. Lo primero que tenemos que hacer es hacer un doblez en la parte izquierda de la alfombra, donde nos vamos a encontrar una llave pequeñita.
Ah, aquí.
Y ahora vamos a buscar un pasadizo secreto, que para ello lo que vamos a hacer es corresponder las estatuas que hemos ido recogiendo con una serie de libros que podemos encontrar en tanto la estantería esa que tenemos enfrente como la estantería de la derecha. Hay que buscar libros que se correspondan a cada uno de los de las estatuas. En este caso, la estatua del hombre viejo sería El viejo y el mar, la estatua del hombre joven sería El libro juventud, y la estatua del niño juventud y la estatua del hombre joven sería El libro del hombre invisible. Lo que hacemos es coger el libro correspondiente y colocar la estatua que esté asociada a dicho libro. Y cuando esto ocurra, en la parte de las estanterías de la derecha se abrirá un pasadizo secreto que nos dejará acceder a una dependencia donde se encuentra Jack. Para obtener más información, le vamos a dar el pergamino.
Quick, give me the parchment. They came to find it. Great heavens, it's as I thought. It means, in his dwelling place of dead Belial, Cthulhu dreams and waits. Do those words ring any bells?
I've come across the name Cthulhu in old manuscripts concerning primitive religions. Nothing more.
Mr. Parker, man has not always been the master of this world. Many ages ago there was a race of gods, the great old ones.
But how can you believe such?
I have little time. Rightly or wrongly, many believe that by using certain incantations, these loathsome creatures can be brought back to reign over us once more.
How?
There are portals through which the great old ones will enter in exchange for the promise of power, wealth, and immortality. There are men prepared to perpetuate the hideous ancestral cults and work for the return of these gods.
What are these gods? Where are they?
They are at once far away and very near. Their names are Dagon, Yog-Sothoth, Nyarlathotep, Cthulhu. There are many others. The passing of Halley's comet coincides with a favorable astral conjuncture.
How can I stop them?
In two nights from now, in the center of a stone circle, the guardian of the portal will materialize. It must not be allowed to happen. You will find here a book called the Necronomicon. Within its cursed pages, you will find the formula you need. Be warned, Parker. The book drives men to madness. Do not take it from here.
But if you...
My desk. The message. That man will help you. Some of Ilsmuth's citizens will seek your destruction by whatever means possible. Read the message in the safety of your room.
But
Narakamus, the sorcerer, even dead, wields ghastly power. Remember? More things in heaven and earth, Horatio, than are dreamt of in your
I won't forget, Tobias Jug.
Ahora podemos acceder al Necronomicon y al mensaje. El Necronomicon vamos a utilizar la llave pequeñita que hemos encontrado antes para abrirlo y tenemos que dejarlo en la habitación. Y el mensaje solo lo podremos leer en nuestras dependencias. Así que hay que hacer eso o perderemos la partida de una muerte nada agradable.
This little key must open the lock on this book. The ancients were. The ancients are. The ancients will be. Yog-Sothoth knows the portal. Yog-Sothoth is the portal. Yog-Sothoth is the guardian and the key to the portal. To summon him, stand inside the circle at the appointed hour. Yagnai, Thathaik, Nagha, Yog-Sothoth. Three times he must be summoned, and there will be light. The portal will shut. I'll put it back in its place.
Una vez que hemos dejado el Necronomicon en su sitio, nos vamos a volver a nuestra habitación, a nuestra dependencia, y es el sitio donde vamos a leer el mensaje.
Lives where the three colors float. From there, 100 messages leave. He's recently been looking for the Forgotten Symmetry, which is on the map everybody can see. Now, where have I seen a map of the region? And what are these three colors and 100 messages?
El lugar de los tres colores y los 100 mensajes no es ni más ni menos que la oficina de correos, así que nos vamos a dirigir inmediatamente para allá.
It's Mr. Parker. How about a drink with poor old Jed?
I'd love to, but a little later. I'm in something of a hurry.
Another time, then.
Hablamos con la persona que se encuentra tras el mostrador y después de hablar con ella nos dejará pasar a la siguiente sala para ver el mapa.
Hey, Miss Gilchrist. I was told there's a map of the region hanging up here, but I can't seem to...
Oh, well, David Underhouse asked me for it, and I lent it to him. The poor man can't get around, you know. Such a cruel world.
Where can I find him?
There, the door at the end. Interested in Indians, are you? Mr. Underhouse is very keen. He's been looking for that cemetery for months.
I beg your pardon?
The cemetery of some Indian tribe, the Muckamucks or something. Well, he found it, and my, is he happy. Now why should a fine man like that take such an interest in savages?
As for savagery, I think the Indians might have learned a thing or two from the 7th Cavalry.
Mr. Parker, my father often said, the only good Indian's a dead one. And he knew what he was talking about. Now, if you'll excuse me, some of us have work to do.
Thank you for defending the Indians, Mr. Parker. No, the walls don't have ears. They are merely very thin. I believe you want to consult the map of this region. Please, go right ahead.
I'm very grateful, Mr. Underhouse.
So, Mr. Parker, why don't we discuss the Micmac?
I'm afraid I didn't make myself very clear. It's precisely because I'm so ignorant about Indian culture that I'm here. Have you heard of Naracomas?
Indeed. He was the last of a particular branch of the Micmac tribe, a branch known as They Who Worship the Night Howler. By Night Howler they meant Nyarlathotep. How did you hear about him?
We met. He almost killed me.
But he is supposed to have died 70 years ago.
I can only tell you what happened.
I know it's none of my business, but may I ask what you're looking for on the map?
Do you know this place here?
That's the Stone Circle, the location of the Micmac burial ground. And you say you know nothing of Indian culture?
Does the name Cthulhu mean anything to you?
Let me answer you with a question of my own. Did you know that those who worship Nyarlathotep are rewarded with a very particular gift? Immortality?
Do you think that...
There are names it is wise never to pronounce, and people it is wise never to meet.
Are you talking about the Hambleton family?
An ancient curse hangs over Ilsmith. Some of the townspeople practice strange rituals in the worship of foul and age-old gods. I wanted to know more, and my curiosity cost me my legs.
And Tobias Jug, who led me to you, is dead.
Dead? Dear God, there is no time to lose. Andrew Arlington isn't here. The diary containing the origin of the curse is locked inside his office safe.
I'll get the diary and bring it.
No, you'd better leave it where it is. There's no point in alerting them, is there? I can give you some information. I know the combination to the safe is made up of a number of digits.
You don't happen to know what they are?
When I discovered it, just before my accident, the digits had something to do with the Bible.
Well, thank you for your help.
You can thank me by bringing me a photo of the Stone Circle.
That's a promise.
Ya tenemos un montón de información, salimos de la oficina de correos y nos vamos a encontrar con la señora Picot, que sabemos que tiene una Biblia y tenemos que intentar conseguir que nos la dé para seguir las pistas que nos acaban de indicar, pero que de primera no va a estar muy por la labor.
Good morning, ladies.
Hello, Mr.
Gloria, I forbid you to speak to this person. He is nothing more than a ruffian who fights in the streets.
That's a little unfair, Miss Picot. Young Webster needed some help, and it was my duty as a Christian to...
Good Christians do not spend their time in bars, Mr. Parker. Good day to you.
Please forgive me if my behavior upsets you. Would you mind if I borrowed...
I hardly like to be without it. This Bible is the last reminder of my great-aunt, a most God-fearing woman.
Nos vamos a ir hacia la derecha, hasta la tienda de ultramarinos, y allí vamos a hablar de nuevo con el tendero y le vamos a comprar todo lo que tiene, que va a ser un guardapelo, un broche y de nuevo unas nuevas placas fotográficas.
I just dropped in to say hello.
That's very kind of you.
I'll take the locket.
Thank you. Come back soon. What can I get for you, Mr. Parker?
I'll take the brooch.
Thank you. Come back soon. What can I get for you, Mr. Parker?
I'd like another set of photosensitive plates.
Hold on a second. There are four plates. That'll be $10, please.
Una vez que ya hemos hecho todas nuestras compras, vamos a irnos a ver de nuevo a la señora Picot y le vamos a ofrecer tanto el guardapelo como el broche, y con eso pues al final nos va a dar por fin la Biblia.
Don't try buying my respect with worthless, shiny balls. How kind of you, Mr. Parker. It's almost like the one I lost last week. I don't know how to thank you. Here is my Bible. Please take good care of it.
En la Biblia vamos a tener tres pasajes marcados, que son los que vamos a leer, y nos van a dar una serie de números que vamos a tener que utilizar en el futuro.
Thank you so much.
Así que la leemos, y el primer lugar que vamos a visitar posteriormente es el ayuntamiento.
Page 303, St. Paul's Epistles, chapter 3, verse 16. Destruction and despair will cross their path. Page 181, Acts of the Apostles, chapter 1, verse 15. And Peter stood up among the assembled brethren, some 80. page 303. St. Paul's Epistles, chapter 3, verse 16. Page 345. The Apocalypse according to St. John, chapter 13, verse 8. And the number of the beast is 666.
Nos encaminamos al ayuntamiento y tenemos que dejar que conseguir que nos dejen subir a la parte de arriba. Así que con el trabajador que se encuentra en la parte de abajo tenéis que seleccionar la línea de diálogo que vais a ver ahora.
Ah, you'll have to come back later. This is my break.
I simply want a few words with the mayor.
Not possible. The mayor is not here at this time.
I don't want to bother you, but the mayor suggested I enjoy the view of Ilsmouth from his...
Ah, yes. You must be the photographer. It's about the next edition of the Ilsmouth Town Hall Journal, I suppose.
No, I'm the reporter.
Well, all right. But don't go touching anything. Reporters. Can't leave anyone alone.
Nos encaminamos a la parte de arriba. Y vamos a ver una especie de armario. Vamos a ver que hay distintos cuadros, pero que delante de una especie de armario nos encontramos un cuadro. Ese cuadro lo vamos a inspeccionar y nos vamos a dar cuenta que esconde detrás una caja fuerte. El número de la combinación de la caja fuerte lo vamos a coger de uno de los pasajes que habíamos leído anteriormente en la Biblia.
There's a handle hidden in this painting. Let's see. It's exactly as I thought. No, that doesn't work.
La combinación numérica que tenemos que utilizar en este caso es 345 y nos vamos a encontrar un diario y una pitillera que al abrirla nos va a contener una especie de recibo de un apartado de correos que posteriormente tendremos que utilizar en la oficina de correos. Pero inicialmente lo que vamos a hacer es leernos el diario, que para eso se va a sentar ahí en la mesa del alcalde, y posteriormente lo tendremos que dejar de nuevo en la caja fuerte para no levantar sospechas.
Why don't I unscrew this case? What's this inside? A piece of paper.
My name's Jonas. Jonas Hamilton. In 1829, I made my fortune, the hard way, at sea. Even the big Boston businessmen were jealous of my fishery. At that time, I became interested in the occult. I read only the most accursed books, and then I met Noracomus. He initiated me into the ancient practices. At last, I was in contact with those from the outside. Each day, my knowledge grew deeper. My body regenerated. My hands were at last palmed. But the ancients wanted more. much more! I gave in. My own wife, Lavina, was the bargain, you see. I screamed out the invocations, and he came. The sea would take all I cherished, but that was of no importance. The pitiless god Dagon wanted that union. That was the price of my immortality. Two sons were born of that wondrous night, Wilbur and Curtis. The second of them betrayed and abandoned me, but the first followed in my footsteps. He has my gift. He can beg to the stones. They all think I'm dead. Only he who reaches that place where water, earth, and sky come together can find my burial place. Our work was destroyed in 1834, all because of that accursed Boleskin. But gods are immortal, and time means nothing to me. Nobody can destroy the families without the statuettes which I guard, and the secret incantation. In 1910, the comet will come again, and the prophecy will come true. The great ancients will reign. I will swim beside my Lavina in the abyss, and we shall sing the praises of he who cannot be named.
I'll put the diary back in its place.
Nos vamos a la oficina de correos, le entregamos a la encargada de la oficina de correos el recuerdo que acabamos de conseguir y nos van a dar un paquete que contiene una túnica verde como la del personaje que estábamos persiguiendo antes.
So, you're on an errand for Mr. Hambleton. That'll be $3, please. That must be a frock. Mr. Hambleton always orders them from Boston.
Thank you. Good day.
Bien, pues ahora, al más puro estilo de Assassin's Creed, vamos a tener que disfrazarnos con la túnica para que parezcamos el otro personaje y que nos dejen acceder a una zona en concreto. Lo que ocurre es que no nos va a valer cualquier sitio para colocarnos esta túnica o este hábito. Así que vamos a buscar un sitio bueno para escondernos para que nos podamos cambiar de ropa sin ser vistos y que nos pillen el truco. Para ello nos tenemos que dirigir a una zona que se encuentra al norte de la plaza central, donde se encuentra un pozo. Si nos colocamos detrás del pozo, nos permitirá cambiar de ropa.
Shouldn't be disturbed here.
Una vez que ya estamos ataviados con nuestra nueva ropa, pues ya nos van a confundir con el señor Wilbur, así que nos vamos a ir a la derecha y va a haber una serie de personajes que nos van a dejar acceder al faro gracias a nuestro disfraz.
Ah, hello, Mr. Wilbur. Everything okay? Oh, we can go. Mr. Wilbur is there.
Nobody. I think I'll take these ridiculous clothes off.
Una vez que ya tengamos otra vez nuestras ropas normales, pues lo que tenemos que hacer es utilizar la escala de cuerda para llegar a la zona superior de el faro. En la parte superior, pues vamos a conseguir o vamos a ver un reloj de sol que tiene un pequeño mecanismo que nos va a abrir una puertecilla y en esa puertecilla vamos a ver unas alas. Además, a su izquierda vamos a ver también una especie de receptáculo donde vamos a encontrar cera.
It's a small sundial with a metal point at the center. I have the feeling that the point serves some purpose. Well, well, a mechanism which opens.
Ahora que tenemos la vela, la vamos a colocar en el suelo y vamos a hacer uso de la lupa para conseguir encenderla para que se derrita y consigamos cera para utilizar con las alas. Al utilizar la lupa, pues nos va a cambiar la perspectiva y vamos a tener que mover la lupa hasta irnos a la zona de la mecha para que se prenda la vela. Y como si de Ícaro y de Dalo se tratase, pues nos vamos a crear con la cera y las alas un mecanismo para salir volando y vamos a terminar apareciendo en el bosque.
Why not use the wax from this candle to strengthen the wing? Let's hope it holds.
Con eso iremos al campamento gitano.
Now, let's just hope this thing works. Otherwise...
Pero ya lo que hagamos allí quedará para nuestro siguiente vídeo de la guía de Shadow of the Comet. Así que yo, como siempre, me despido hasta el siguiente vídeo de Insert Coin. ¡Hasta luego!
Where am I?
Have no fear, Mr. Parker. You are safe now.
Thank you.
You were the only one brave enough to act. Do you feel better?
Yes, thank you.
God be with you. The danger is great for you. We spent the night in that accursed forest, and we heard the devilish chanting. We saw Mr. Wilbur.
Be quiet, Pepto. I can help you. I can make the shadows speak, the shadows that wander in other worlds. They may be of help to you.